Hey guys, it's Peter here. How about learning to build a cool new slider? Let's dive right in. It's got all the fancy stuff. Mouse parallax effect for the layers, Ken Burns effect for the background, and thumbnails for navigation. Also, there's a highlighted heading layer on each slide which makes the heading stand out. I can't wait to teach you how to build this stunning slider. So let's get started. First, start with creating a new project. Most default settings are fine for me, but I'll change the slider name to be more meaningful. I also need to increase the slider height to 800 pixels. The slider should be full width, so I'll click on Create. Alright, let's start the editing by setting up the controls. First, disable the arrows because we don't need them. Next, scroll down and enable the thumbnails. Here we need to adjust the image size to be 80 by 80 pixels. When that's done, adjust the position of the thumbnails. Instead of outer bottom, they need to be in bottom center position. Change the offset to minus 40 pixels, which would make half the thumbnails appear on top of the slider. By default, the thumbnails appear at the left side of the slider, but this slider needs the thumbnails in center. Finally, we need to adjust the styling of the thumbnail bar. Remove the dark background color and reduce the padding to zero, then apply the changes. At the thumbnail style option, change the normal thumbnail opacity to 100, so they'll be fully visible. Next, give them 3 pixel border and set the border radius for the rounded corners. Switch to the Active tab to customize the thumbnail of the selected slide. Set the border to 3 pixels and set a white background color. Click on Apply. By default, every control is hidden on mobile devices. Let's show this thumbnail control on mobile. We can check how the slider looks in the preview anytime without having to save. The thumbnails look great there. So let's move on to the animations. Go to the Animations tab and change the main animation from horizontal to fade. After that, scroll down to add the Ken Burns effect. We need the downscale right effect. Click on Apply to close this window and add the selected effect. Now we need to change the speed to super slow and the strength to super soft. Okay, it's time to save the slider and move on to the slide configuration. First, click on New Slide, then select Image. Here you can select all images you want to use as a slide background. Go to the first slide. The first thing we need to do here is to change the slide thumbnail. Go to the Content tab of the slide and pick the thumbnail. Next, we will create the content area. Add the new row and remove the second column. Set a white background to the row. At this point, this color also helps seeing the row in the editor. The maximum width can prevent the row from being too wide. So set 500 pixels max width. Then align the row to the left. Now add the highlighted heading layer. The text is white and isn't visible. So go to the Style tab to customize it. The color should be a nice red color. And the font family needs to be Kevit. Don't forget to increase the font size and make the text bold. Reduce the line height and the letter spacing. The highlighted heading layer can display a text before the highlight, but we don't need that. Change the text at the highlighted text field. We also need to change the highlight type and color. Next, we need to add the text layer. Change the font color to dark gray. Select Nunito, at the font family. And increase the font size. it's time to add the call to action button. Add the button layer and change its label. Use Nunito font here, and make the text bigger and bolder. Set the background color to red. Then switch to hover to customize the hover state. Here we need a lighter red color, which will create a nice looking hover effect. Set the border radius and adjust the paddings. I'll use these values, because they adjust the padding size based on the size of the font, so the button will look better on smaller screens. The last layer we will put into the row is another text layer. Change the text. Set a red color. And reduce the text size. It's time to move on to the spacing. Set a top padding on the row. Then set a bigger padding on the left and right sides. You can adjust the padding on the sides if you press and hold the shift button. To create some distance between the heading and text, give a button margin to the heading. You can create space between the text and the button the same way. The bottom text layer needs 5 pixels top distance as well. To ensure that the layers can never overlap the thumbnails, let's set a bottom padding. Here comes the fun part, adding the layers which have the parallax effect. Switch to absolute and add an image layer. Let's change the image. Select the picture and drag it to the top right edge of the row. To ensure that the layer stays where you put it, open up the layer list and drag the absolute positioned image layer into the row, but not into the column. Go back to the image layer, switch to the style tab, and change its align to right and its vertical align to top. You can set its position either by drag and dropping the layer in the canvas or by setting the left and top positions here. Change the parallax value to 2, which will make the layer react to a mouse movement slightly. Add the remaining image layers in absolute position the same way. Each image has a different parallax value, which makes the movement unique. When your layers are in their places, set an incoming layer animation to the row. Start from the bottom fade animation, but reduce the offset Y to minus 20 pixels. Now open the timeline to manage the animations. At the highlighted heading, you can set the animation of the highlight at the Content tab. Set a delay to the highlight, so it would run after the animation on the row. This animation needs to run faster, so reduce the duration. Okay, select the first absolute positioned image layer and set its incoming animation to top fade. Change the easing to back out. And set the offset X to 200 pixels. To make the animations more spectacular, change the rotate Z value. Now I will copy this animation and paste it on the other images. At the second image, set the offset X to minus 50. This will make it come from the right side. Then reduce the offset Y. Now set up the incoming animation of the last layer. Now I will change only the offset X value. Finally, adjust the animations of these absolute position layered on the timeline. Just drag the incoming animation marked with the blue color to set when the animations should start. Play the animations to see how they look. Now that the effects are done, it's time to set up the slider for smaller screens. The tablet view looks good. I'll move the images a little bit and align them to the corners. The tablet view is done, let's check the mobile. The texts are too big, so I reduce their size. I don't need the absolute positioned images, so I'll hide them on mobile using the eye icon. Finally, I'll adjust the spacing of the layers. We need more space at the top and bottom, so I'll add padding to the slide. The mobile view looks good now. As you can see, the desktop view hasn't changed. Let's preview the slider. The slider looks good, and all animations and effects are working fine. It's time to save. You can create the other slides in the same way. I hope you liked the video and you could follow it. If you want to see similar videos in the future, make sure to subscribe to our channel. See you in the next video.